Hi students, how are you? Yes, today we are going to see naming of alicyclic compounds. Tell me, what is alicyclic compounds? Alicyclic compounds means which formed as a cyclic but which is not having like benzene ring. Okay, when the benzene ring comes, we can say aromatic. Yes, so there is no benzene ring like hexagonal structure, but they formed a cyclic compound. They are called alicyclic compound, or less than 6 carbon, they formed a cyclic compound. They can call alicyclic compound. For alicyclic compound, what is the rules we have to follow according to IUPAC? Yes, one by one we will see now. First, we may have the normal alicyclic compound. We don't have any substituent in the cyclic compound. What are they? Very simple. We can go with propane. Cyclopropane. This means what? You just remember, all carbon we have one CH2. So this structure only I have written like a triangle. What's the name of this one? 3 carbon with cyclic ring. So cyclopropane. Then tell me, how many carbons are there? Each carbon one, each corner one carbon. So cyclobutane. Then if you have 5 member ring, this is called cyclopentane. Okay sir, suppose I have here one double bond, then how I can name, right? See, only one double bond, you know, there is no any other substitution, so you need not to give any number, simply cyclobutane. But there is a double bond, so the secondary primary suffix will change cyclobutane. Okay, right. Then see, cyclooctane also there. I told wrongly, more than 6 means, okay. No benzene ring, benzenoid structure not formed, but they formed a cyclic compound, means we can say alicyclic compound, even though 8 carbon. How many carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 carbon, even though formed as a cyclic compound, we need not to call that is benzene, because benzenoid compound should have certain rule. It should apply, it should obey certain rule. So if it is not obeyed, means we can say alicyclic compound. So 8 carbon, cyclooctane. What's the name of this compound? Cyclooctane. Yes. Now, sir, I have some substituent in the compounds. For example, here I have one CH3. Then, how do you name? You have to give number for this carbon. So, 1-methyl cyclooctane. Right? The same way you can take other compounds. What are the other compounds? Butane, cyclobutane with one substituent. Methyl, 1-methyl, because there is substituent. Or simply we can write methyl cyclobutane. So only one substituent is present. So you need not to mention even number. Simply cyclobutane with methyl group. So methyl cyclobutane. Yes. Okay. Next, if you have two substituents in a single compound, like you take a 5 member ring, in that we have ethyl group C2H5 and also methyl group. Now, definitely you should give the number. Okay. From which you have to give number? Which carbon will you start first? See, you should follow that priority. Priority in the sense, if you have functional group, you will give the order. You will follow the order of functional group, right? But here we don't have functional group, but that is, we have to follow alphabetic order. Ethyl, methyl, which one will come? E, ethyl. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So cyclopentane, 5 carbon. First carbon having ethyl group, second carbon having methyl. So 1 ethyl, 2 methyl, cyclopentane. Okay. So the same way, if you have more than that, how do you give? See, we'll see some examples. One more, for example, what is this? Don't say benzene. Benzene means it should have three double bond inside the benzene ring. There is no benzene ring, so this is called cyclohexane. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 carbon cyclohexane. In that cyclohexane, we have 3 substitution like that. Okay. If we have, how you name? Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 4. Dimethyl cyclohexane. Dimethyl cyclohexane. Next, if you have, see in the 5 member ring, small twist. See, here I have C2H5 ethyl group. Here 2 methyl group in the same carbon is substituted. Then now how you give? Sir, as we told already, you should follow the alphabetic order. So 1 ethyl, 2, 2 dimethyl cyclopentane. Wrong. See, now we are giving the priority for primary carbon, secondary carbon. What is primary carbon? The carbon having 2 hydrogen means we will say primary carbon. Carbon having only 1 hydrogen, secondary carbon. Carbon don't have any hydrogen, tertiary carbon. See, if you see here, CH2 is there. One of the hydrogen is replaced with C2H5. Here what happened? See, without any substitution, I told there is CH2 group. If there one substitution, you can write like this. Another substitution, another hydrogen also replaced. So, now this is tertiary carbon. Right, because of this tertiary carbon and secondary carbon, according to the priority of tertiary carbon, you should give number here, then 2. As usual, the remaining 4, 5. So, but while writing the name, we should follow the alphabetic order. Listen carefully, for giving number, priority, only we should give for tertiary carbon. But name, 2 ethyl, alphabetic order you should follow. 2 ethyl, 1, 1 dimethyl cyclopentane. Okay, yes. Next, one different compound in cyclohexane compound, there is double bond also. One side we have ethyl group, another side we have methyl group. Now, see, you just make it like this because you will have the doubt. Now, there is a 2 substituent. Okay, then what will you do? Which one is correct? Right? As usual, where is the tertiary carbon? Here, okay. So you should start number, but you should keep in your mind that double bond functional group is present. If there is no functional group, as usual, you will follow either tertiary secondary carbon or alphabetic order. But here, there is a double bond also one of the functional group, so you should follow the priority for double bonded carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the correct answer. So first carbon having double bond, then second carbon having methyl group, fifth carbon having ethyl group, right? Suppose you can ask, sir, if I am giving number like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so substituent number will increase. If you give this side, 2 and 5 will come. If you give this anti-clockwise direction, 3 and 6 will come. So number you should not go long. Okay, that means substituents should carry the least number. Okay, so 5, 6 number, so hex, double bond is present means 1 ene, because first carbon having double bond, so 1 ene. Second carbon having methyl, fifth carbon having ethyl, so 5 ethyl, 2 methyl, hex 1 ene, right? Very good. Next, in case cyclic compound is that as well, the substituent also having more number of carbon, so which one will you take as a parent chain? What is the first example is given? Cyclobutane. Don't think it's a diamond shape. Okay, 4 carbon. Here I have 3 carbon substituent. How? In the same chain. Remember? So the outer substituent having 3 carbon, cyclic compound 4 carbon. So which one is the parent chain? 4 carbon compound. Okay. But you just remember the side substituent don't have any functional group. There is no functional group even the substituent as well in the cyclic compound. Then you have to count the number of carbon which one having more number, that should be taken as a parent chain, remaining taken as a substituent. Okay, now this is a parent chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, this is substituent. So first carbon having what? Propane. What propane? The second carbon only attached. So 2 propyl. Propane is not right. Propyl. Then 4 carbon means what? Cyclobutane. Okay. Yes. Next compound. See. How many carbons are given? Yes. Four carbon. Now you check it, my dear students. Substituent, that means the branch having 4 carbon, but the cyclic compound having only 3. So now tell me which one is the parent chain. Yes, this is the parent chain. Our substituent nothing but cyclopropane. So how do you write? The second carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Second carbon, there is a branch as a cyclopropane. So, 2 cyclopropyl. 4 carbon means butane. Okay. Now, is that functional group? For example, cyclobutane. There is a double bond also where we have here. Let's see here. So here you should follow the priority order for functional group. So already we have studied for normal aliphatic compound. In the same order you can follow here also, right? Now if you see the priority for Cl as well, double bond only having more priority than chlorine. Halogen having less priority than that of double bond and triple bond. So double bonds only you should give the number. So 1, 2, 3, so first and second carbon, so 4 carbon means a cyclobutane 1 ene, then there is a substituent in the third carbon, 3 chloro, so 3 chloro cyclobutane 1 ene is the name of this compound. Okay, next. Some other functional group we will see. See, double bond halogen, the comparison very important. Then butyl with one all the substituent. Okay, how the CH3 CH CHO, am I right? Yes. Now even the four carbon in the cyclic compound, but you see in the branch or in the linear structure having functional group, so functional group containing group only taken as a parent chain. So this is our substituent. Okay, priority should go with the functional carbon 1 2 3. So second carbon have a cyclobutyl group, 2 cyclobutyl, then 3 carbon propanolidehyde, then propane, the single bond only, so primary suffix ANE, right? The last E should be replaced with the aldehyde, means AL. So propane 1 AL, because first carbon having AL, but usually aldehyde and acid will come in end of the carbon, so that one you need not to write. Okay, yes, the same way one more example with the cyclohexane. Okay, how many carbons here I have? Double bond O, CH3, then here how many carbons are there? 2 more carbon. Yes, for this compound is there any double bond? No. You check number of carbon, 1 2 3 4 5, here 6, but ketone functional group is present in the linear chain, so this is taken as a substituent. Okay, right, then double bond O should carry the least number, so second carbon having double bond O, right? So third carbon we have cyclohexyl, then 5 carbon pentane, the so root word pent, only single bond, so ANE primary suffix, and but the last E is replaced with double bond O, you should mention as ketone, so 2-one. So ketone present means the last E should be replaced with ONE, right? Ketone. Next, alicyclic ring itself directly attached functional group, or it may have multiple double bond. Okay, you should follow the priority that already we know that I hope. Okay, now the cyclic compound having 4 carbon as well, one double bond also functional group present, the linear, these are, that means linear structure also having functional group. Now which one you should take as a parent chain? See, here also you should take this one, because double bond and CHO, if you compare, which one having more priority? CHO. So this is our substituent. So 4 carbon, the third carbon 1 2 3, second carbon we have cyclobutyl, but butenal, because double bond present here itself. Okay, so here also you want to give number 1 2 3 4. Okay, so cyclo 1 comma 2, 1 minute, 2 enyl, cyclobut, as usual you write cyclobut, listen carefully, the cyclobut present double bond. So where we have the double bond, 1 2, primary suffix 2, then which is attached in the first, so you can give number like this, because substituent only, you know where it is attached, in the first carbon, so 1 I. So this totally written for this cyclic compound, 2 cyclobut 2 E 1 E9, they are YL. YL indicates usually butyl, propyl, pentyl, like we will say, no, that compound. Then three carbon means propane. So single one only, E should be replaced with Al. So propanol. Okay. So I'll check that compound name once again. 2-cyclobutylpropanol. 2-cyclobut 3 2 in 1 Y then propanol. Yes. So this group you can write inside the bracket. Why we should write inside the bracket? Because up to here, this separate group itself one substituent for this parent chain. So in the parent chain, this group one substituent, but inside we have double bond some substituent. That's why we are giving inside the bracket. The same way, one more difficult compound we'll discuss. We'll take by 5-member ring. There is a double bond also. Then here CH2, CH3, CH2, COOH. Is it correct, my dear students? Yes. So now, which one is the parent chain? Even though double bond, we have the acid group. So priority goes to acid group 2, 3, 4. So in the parent chain, we have two substitutions. Okay. So which one you should give the priority first? Okay. 5 member ring, double bond. So you should give number for this one. So there is a substituent started 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So first carbon is attached in the chain, but the fourth carbon of the parent chain. So 4 inside the bracket. We should write about this substituent. How do you write? Cyclo 5 carbon pent. Then there is a double bond in third carbon, 3 in 1 Y. Okay. Then one more substitution, 3 methyl. 4 carbon means butane. Single bond present means butane, primary suffix. The last E should be replaced with a OIC acid. So 4 cyclopent, 3 in 1 Y, 3 methyl butanoic acid is the name of this compound. Okay. Yes, make it fast. Then we have one different compound, like 2 substitution or 3 substitution is same cyclic compound. Listen, one side the functional group directly attached in the cyclic compound. On the side we have like this one more carbon, yes, propanoic acid. For this compound, how do you name? See, even though the functional group is in the 5 member ring, here we have 2 functional group. Even though one functional group, we have the highest priority for acid. So this group totally taken as a substituent. Okay. We may get confusion, that's why we are seeing all the examples. Okay, right, 1, 2, 3, right, the third carbon we have 1, 2, 3, 4, this side you give 3, so 3 nitro cyclo pentane or pentyl, because substituent, you know, pentyl, which is connected in the third carbon of the propanoic acid. So 3 carbon. So prop. Then second carbon having double bond. Prop 2E. First carbon having acid group. OIC acid. So 3. Here 3 inside also 3 for nitro. 3. 3 nitro cyclopentyl prop 2E OIC acid. Okay. This E you can remove, you can join the name. That is also correct. Propionic acid. The E you can remove, you can add OIC acid. Now, the next compound. Cyclic compound having one functional group. Side branch having the same functional group. Here we have OHQ. Now tell me, which one is the parent chain? Different functional group means we will follow the priority order. Now, as usual, both having same functional group means which one having more number of carbon. So, the remain is taken as a substituent, right? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then, cyclo. First, write the name of substituent. 3 carbon. 1, 2, 3. Second carbon having OH group. Then, 2 hydroxy. 3 carbon. Propyl. This group attached in the second substituent, second number in the cyclic compound. So 2 hydroxy propyl. Then you have to write about the cyclo compound, right? So alcohol means how you name parent chain, hexane. What hexane? Cyclohexane. Cyclohex, only single bond A. The last E should be replaced with the OL. 1 OL, right? So all the numbers are very important. 2 hydroxy propyl cyclohexane 1 OL. Okay, next CH2. I think one more CH2 is there. So like this, 2 cyclic compound is present. Which one is taken as a parent chain, right? If the more than one cyclic compound comes, please take the linear chain as a parent chain. Both are considered as a substituent even though they are having more number of carbon than linear structure. Now tell me 1, 2, 1, 2. We having 2 substituent, dicyclo propyl. Then 2 carbon means ethane. Is it correct, my dear? 1 cyclobutyl, 2 cyclopropyl, ethane. Okay. The same compound, if you change one more small changes, here we have butane. Then what's the name? See, already I told for previous one. 1 propyl. Propyl is first or butyl, because butyl you should give. So 2 butyl cyclobutyl, which is contained in the first carbon. So 1 cyclobutyl, because alphabetic order you should follow. 2 cyclopropyl ethane. Okay, if it is same, you can write like dihydride, but different means you should differently write within the bracket. Next, 2 cyclic compound directly attached, then how will you name? Then one more benzene ring. Now only we are using benzene ring, my dear students. Okay, right. So benzene ring, alicyclic compound. So which one is the parent chain? Definitely benzene ring. This is our substituent. So in the benzene ring, cyclopentane or pentyl. So substituent means pentyl, you should say benzene. Okay, right. The last few examples for alicyclic compound. Hexane with the acid group. Now, why we have taken this? Because if you take benzene ring, right, this acid group you will not consider. So, benzenic acid, like you will say. The same way, here also, if you have like this cyclic compound, the cyclic compound is nothing but cyclohexyl. Okay, this is nothing but carboxylic acid. Because the carboxylic acid also having one functional group. What we have studied, functional group present in the cyclic or linear means you should take the parent chain. So this is substituent parent chain. Cyclohexane is the substituent. Here cyclohexane carbonic acid also you can write, no problem. The next one. There is two substitution, one acid group, another one amide group. COH just means what? Amide group. Okay. Now, how you name? Prior you should give for acid group. Four carbon. So, cyclobutane. First carbon having acid group. And also, that acid group separately will say carboxylic acid. Then cyclobutane. The cyclobutane, second carbon having amide group. Amide group in substituent means how you name? Amyl. Okay. So, 2-carboamyl. The substituent. Then, cyclobutane. 1-carboxylic acid. Okay. Right. So almost we have finished all the examples given in the book for alicyclic compound naming system. Okay. Now we can see little bit about aromatic compounds naming. Okay. So aromatic means what? Which having benzene ring. So benzene ring present means it is called aromatic compound. That we will see in the next class. Thank you.